the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Today's Gospel, the first Gospel at least, from St. Matthew, with the parable of the unforgiving servant. We've all heard it. We always need to look at these things afresh. At least I hope we've all heard it. We should have all heard it. The idea that we have to forgive each other trespasses so we will be forgiven needs to weigh on our hearts every day. There's no option for not having forgiveness at any moment, in any second. One thing that the Lord is, I've said to many of you, is absolutely non-negotiable about. No gray area is forgiveness. He doesn't give any circumstantial, you know, reasons for not doing it. There's no excuse. It must be done. Remember, years ago, I was listening to this lecture that really struck me to heart, and it always strikes me to heart when I listen to it, because of how far I have to go in the spiritual life. Really, we all do, but I know it wounds my heart. It was a lecture given by Father Zacharias of Essex. Some of you have told this story. But he's a very extremely humble man. I've never met him myself, but just what I know of him and people that know him, what I've read of him and heard of him, it's profound. Father Zacharias was doing a talk on, of course, the hidden man of the heart. And in the last lecture, for some reason, he did this lecture on the Orthodox understanding of tongues. Well, this rose all kinds of questions to the surface. And at the end of it, one man started describing to Father Zacharias, a certain who will remain nameless, at least for this setting, faith healer on the TV, who at one point in his life had been an Orthodox Christian as a child, but had left Orthodoxy, and if anyone listened to him for a few minutes on the TV, there's nothing close to Orthodox Christianity that the man preaches. Quite the contrary, I've heard it myself many years ago. And he was the one that would put his hands on people and knock them down and supposedly heal them. Very unorthodox behaviors. Well, he asked Father Zacharias about this quite vehemently, just expressing his opinions on this. Indeed, the man is wrong for doing those things. But the man kept trying to push Father Zacharias for an answer. It's obviously someone who had converted, at least in my estimation, the way he sounded. And Father Zacharias just says, yes. Well, he keeps pushing the point. Father Zacharias doesn't answer anything. And he says, you're not going to say anything, are you? He goes, no. You're not going to say anything. Father Zacharias responds, pride. Wound. We talk about everything. I talk about everything. We talk about everyone. Supposedly being nice. Supposedly being kind. Supposedly trying to help them. Father Zacharias went on to say, we know when these things are wrong. Why do we have to talk about them? Let's tell them what they're doing right and work from there. And work from there. Now granted, to add a little bit to that story, which is a beautiful story in itself, there is a time and place for speaking against what's wrong. We have many saints on these walls who did so, and I'm sure Father Zacharias would be willing to do so too if he came to defend the teaching of the church. This wasn't an issue of defending the teaching of the church. It was really an opportunity to bash some individual, not his teaching necessarily. So Father Zacharias declined. And I've heard him say in other lectures and places that he was the disciple of Father Sophronia of Essex, who, well, we all know will be made glorified, recognized as a saint before long. This is in the works, it just hasn't been done yet. And he said that Father Sophronia never, ever, issued a harsh word from his mouth. Always very soft, very meek, very kind. Except in one case. Any evidence of pride. The moment he would sense pride in one of his monks, he said Father Sophronia's words would still be soft and meek, but strong to the point, he said, of crushing bones. He said a couple of times in his life that happened, he said he found himself in his cell weeping and weeping and weeping until he came back, of course, into Father Sophronia's loving embrace every time. But he would not tolerate pride, because pride will keep us from the kingdom of heaven. Imagine if I had been his monk, I would have been there every 5 minutes until he crushed my bones. A broken heart is what God will not despise. We have to be crushed and get rid of our pride. Oh, we have so much of it. How many subtle ways It sneaks in with our opinions and our comments, our little comments about individuals and people when we think we know better. Perhaps we do. But talking about them is not fixing them. Talking about them is not loving them. It's not helping them whatsoever, unless it's something constructive to actually help them. We have to be able to discern that, though. This man today, in the parable, of course, goes to his Lord. He owes him a tremendous amount of money. 10,000 talents. And if you look that up, you'll find various discussions of how much money that actually was. I saw one place where they said it was 200,000 years worth of wages. One place, the emperor of Byzantium had nothing like that in his highest moment. It was an extreme sum that no one could ever pay it off. And that really is our debt before God because of our sins, when he has given us everything. But he falls down when he's unable to pay. The Lord issues a word which would truly crush bones. You and your family and children will be cast in the prison till everything is paid off. But this couldn't be paid off. Not with any means we have, not with any strength of our own. It only had to be from the mercy of this Lord, who in fact is our Lord. Only from mercy. It sounds like a very harsh word, but indeed, if we are willing to hear, quite often the harsh word is what will change our souls. I know if you read the canons of the church, sometimes those words seem extremely harsh. But if we listen to them and follow them, they have the power to heal our souls with medications. Cancer treatment is not easy. It hurts badly, I've been told. But yet it's necessary for the healing of the soul. So this harsh word in this man's case was very necessary. But what does he do? He has a grand opportunity now to be his father Zacharias and run to his cell and weep and change his heart. He doesn't do that. He goes and finds a servant of his who owes him, it says, 100 pence in the King James, 100 denarii, which is basically 1 denarius is a day's wage for a laborer. So 100 denarii would be about a year's worth of labor with him because of, you know, various holidays and Jewish holidays and feast days. A good bit for most common men. But it was, so I've read one place too, that 15 years was a talent, perhaps. Maybe even more. The man could not even barely pay off his debt. So he falls down using the exact same words as the previous man. Forgive me, you have mercy until I can pay off my debt. Grabs him around the throat and casts him into prison. And these servants, of course, see this, who are really representative of the holy angels who see us and our brothers and sisters indeed. And they take him, they go to the Lord and tell him what has happened. And the Lord casts him into prison till it will be paid off, which will never happen. The parable has this man essentially being cast into hell. It is over because he had no mercy, because he would not forgive trespasses, because he was not willing to humble his pride. So every moment of every day, when someone says a harsh word to us, or someone insults us, or someone rebukes us, be like Father Zacharias. Let it crush bones. Be as that man should have been initially. Fall down and thank your Lord for the mercy he has shown you, because indeed we are all worthy of a harsh word if we really crush our pride and think about it. The Lord who has given us everything, the heavens and the earth, food, shelter, everything we could possibly need, and indeed his own body and blood and the church, has given us everything that we need to be healed. To really be perfect as our Father in heaven is perfect. But yet we take offense at everything, and we go out and talk. And we talk about our neighbor, we talk about our brother, we talk about the people we see on the television, we talk about the president, and we talk about the soon-to-be president with harsh, harsh words, which the scriptures forbid. They absolutely forbid us to speak such ways. But yet we all do it. At least I do. God forgive me. But let us make an effort together to stop doing that. It brings to mind, of course, St. Paisios, as very many things do to me. When people would start talking about him in front of him, he would say things like, Oh no, let's talk about my sins. They're far worse. Nobody would do that. If it was in his face, of course. Or he would change the subject. He would talk about God. Or he would say something beautiful about that person. Let's do that. Let's change our way of life. Let us forgive as we want to be forgiven. And use that measure. Let us don't be as the first servant. Let us be as that one when we hear these harsh things, just sigh and pray for the people. As Father Zacharias did. Of course, there is a time when we have to fight wrong and evil and say that it's wrong. That doesn't mean we have to be condemnatory and constantly go around to every house we can find and talk about it and pick up the phone and put it on Facebook and put it on the internet. Doesn't need to be. There's enough poison in the air without that. So God, help us to look at the example of really Father Zacharias and Father Sophroni. This parable which teaches us to be humble. And just another side thought. Imagine what that would do to the Lord's commandment that we'd be judged for every idle word that comes out of our mouth. If we weren't talking about individuals so much that we were upset with or thought they were doing something wrong, imagine there would be a lot more silence in the world and a lot more time for prayer and a lot more time for love and beauty. God help us. Amen.